Good morning. Please remain standing if you're able for the playing of our national anthem. Please be seated. On behalf of PSL Services, the Strive Steering Committee, and the students and staff of StriveU, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the StriveU graduation ceremony recognizing the class of 2019. We are gathered here today to acknowledge the accomplishments of these remarkable men and women. Krista, Dylan, Bridget, Romeal, Molly, and Owen, who have worked tremendously hard to achieve their personal goals over these past 2 years. These six individuals have worked diligently both at StriveU and Purdue University Global. In addition to growing academically in the classroom, they have gained a strong sense of who they are and how they can positively contribute to their new communities. It is an honor and a privilege to be here today celebrating their successes. Let us begin this celebration of achievement. I would like to now introduce the Strive Program Director, Steve Habib.
Thank you, Caroline. Good morning, everybody. The big day. You look ready. It is truly an honor to be here this morning to celebrate with our StriveU graduating class, families, and friends. Congratulations to each of you. Before we move forward with today's events, I would just like to extend a big thank you to our friends here at The Point for allowing us to use this beautiful and very spacious facility for today's celebration. Thank you for your partnership with StriveU and for all the great work that you do for our community. StriveU is fortunate to have created successful public and private partnerships throughout our community over the past 15 years. In 2009, the StriveU Steering Committee created an award to be given annually at graduation, recognizing one or more partners that have enriched the experience for our StriveU students. This year, we are proud to present the Community Partnership Award to the Greater Portland Metro. Our students rely heavily on the Metro system to move about the community, do their shopping, and to get to their jobs. Since our inception, the Metro has partnered with Strive to assist our students to be successful. Every summer, the staff provide a training session for our students to teach them how to read the bus maps, use the apps, and most importantly, the ins and outs of riding the bus. The staff and drivers are very supportive to our students and will take the time to assist them when they are not sure of a situation. Finally, the Metro continues to develop technology that assists all riders to be able to check location of buses, arrival times, and easy payment options. The Greater Portland Metro is a true partner in the work that StriveU does, and we are very pleased to award them the 2019 Community Partner Award. Would you please welcome Greg Jordan, who's the general manager.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the Metro organization, I really want to thank you for this recognition and this award. At Metro, we work hard every day to provide mobility across the Southern Maine region and to provide independent living options for all residents across the region. We are also striving every day to improve our services, and we are honored to count StriveU and all of you as partners in that mission. So thank you very much, and congratulations to all the graduates. We wish you all the best.
Today, StriveU would like to recognize the contributions of two extraordinary individuals by naming them honorary members of the class of 2019. We are proud to present them with a citation for outstanding contributions in promoting equality, opportunity, and independence. Their work, guidance, and dedication have made StriveU stronger and furthered our mission of lifelong learning and the opportunity for independence. Our first recipient is Amy Carson. Amy is an executive assistant at the law firm of Drummond Woodsum. And since 2009, Drummond Woodsum has hired StriveU students to have a paid work experience. Amy is the coordinator and the supervisor of the program. She is recognized by StriveU staff for her patience, her professional support, and her mentoring of our students. Amy mentors our students to be successful at the job site, and this provides them with valuable experience and a positive reference for future jobs. Amy also encourages our students to be involved in extra work events like a summer picnic, bowling outings, Halloween parties, and Christmas parties. Finally, Amy supports Strive by volunteering at Strive Rocks, attending our annual auction, as well as the graduation ceremony. So we want to sincerely thank Amy for her dedication over the years to our students and to our organization. Amy, would you please come forward to accept our honorary degree?
Thank you very much. It's been an honor to be a part of this program for so long. It's changed my life, for sure. Congratulations, graduates. Go get it. Thank you.
Thank you, Amy. Today we are fortunate to have, as our keynote speaker, Ms. Jane Gallivan. Upon moving to Maine in 1982, Jane started her career working with individuals with developmental disabilities at the Pineland Center. She was promoted to a variety of positions at the facility and was part of the administrative team that worked to achieve its final closure. Jane was appointed as the director of the Division of Developmental Disabilities in 1997 and remained in that position until retiring in 2011. There were many challenges that faced the division during those years. And here are a few of the highlights that she and her team were able to accomplish. One was the community consent decree. The state was found in compliance with the federal class action suit filed on behalf of former residents of the state institution of the Pineland Center. The removal of the R word. She worked with the Developmental Disabilities Council and other stakeholders to present legislation to remove inappropriate and offensive labels from all of Maine statutes. She also worked on what we call a supports waiver. She created a supports waiver designed to meet the needs of individuals living at home with their families, and it's now known as Section 29. Assembling the group, which was referred to as Speaking Up for Us, or SUFU. She worked with self-advocates to create a statewide system of self-advocacy with a regional structure to accommodate Maine's large geographic challenges. Self-advocates participate as key stakeholders in multiple committees and task forces. She also worked on the No Sheltered Workshops. The office led the initiative, working with self-advocates, providers, and vocational rehabilitation to transition individuals out of sheltered shops into competitive employment. Shared Living. The office also worked with self-advocates, families, and providers to develop and grow the shared living model. But most importantly, the office worked with a parent group of business leaders and the University of Southern Maine, as well as the Project for Supported Living, to create what is now StriveU. Jane played an instrumental role in assuring that StriveU could become a reality and for it to have a solid foundation for the future. Upon retirement from Maine, Jane was appointed as the Director of Developmental Disability Services in Delaware. And after 4 years, Jane retired again in 2016. She is currently a consultant completing projects in Rhode Island, at UMass Boston, and now in Maine. Jane also served on the board of the National Association of State Directors of Developmental Disability Services and was the president of the board from 2011 to 2014. Jane received what is known as the Ben Sansoni Award, which is a national award in recognition of her outstanding leadership and achievement by a public official in the field of developmental disabilities. Everybody, please welcome Jane Gallivan.
Well, good morning, everyone. I think that announcement is going to be longer than my speech. Well, this year, StriveU is celebrating its 15-year anniversary. As was mentioned, I was very fortunate to have the opportunity to work with a coalition of many dedicated individuals when the very idea of StriveU was brought forth by a group of parents and self-advocates. This dream became reality because of the leadership and partnerships with the Project for Supported Living, parents, self-advocates, the state of Maine, and many volunteers and many fundraisers. I can still recall now Senator, but then Governor King, saying to me, "You need to get this done." That doesn't happen too often when a governor points his finger at your face, you know? Now, years later, I'm honored to be with you to recognize Krista, Dylan, Romeo, Bridget, Molly, and Owen for their successful completion of the StriveU program. These six students have had many challenging adventures over the past 2 years and have met and exceeded their goals. They have had support of their teachers, advisors, families, and friends, and the support from each other. And now these six graduates move into the next phase of their lives, and they will face many new and exciting challenges. They will face those challenges better prepared because they have a strong foundation to build on because of their many experiences that they have had here at StriveU. To parents, families, and friends, your support and guidance will always be needed, and these graduates make their new life decisions. Where will I work? Where will I live? How will I get from one place to another? What new friends will I make along the way? Your love and support from birth to this proud day has helped to shape the very nature of these young folks, and that will never stop or change. As parents watching your child exceed all expectations and grow into independent men and women is thrilling, but also a little frightening. It's never easy to let go, even just a little. Just like your son or daughter, you are going through a transition as well. I commend you and I thank you for supporting your child to attend StriveU. You recognize the value of in providing this post-secondary college experience for your child, not only for its academics, but for the life skills to become an independent adult working in the greater Portland area. To Krista, Dylan, Romeo, Bridget, Molly, and Owen, as you face the next steps along the path of your lives, you will be making many life decisions. You have grown to become more and more independent, but never forget your roots, the love of your family, and keep strong all the friendships you have made along the way. You are leaders now. Many other individuals will be looking to you as examples of success. You are role models. What does that mean? You need to help others to advocate for themselves. You need to teach others about the importance of having a job, having your own money to do the things you enjoy, working hard to learn the skills to live on your own and manage your own apartment. Believe me, cooking and cleaning and doing the laundry is not high on my list, but living my life the way I want to live it is highest on my list, just as it is for you. You must work at keeping relationships strong and your family and your friends close. Loneliness can be very painful. Having friends will make your life fuller. It is important to give back to others, that in giving your time to someone who needs your help or just needs a friend. Volunteer in order to give back to your community, and you will become a real member of that community. Sitting at home playing video games can be fun, but no video game can give you the support and guidance when you're trying to find your way through a tough day. Stay connected to your friends and your family. You've had many work experiences during your time at StriveU. Finding the career choice that is the right fit for you is not easy. Don't be afraid to try something new and reach higher and higher for all kinds of achievements. Don't settle. Push forward always and never stop trying new things. I bet that none of you, anyone here today, remembers your high school graduation speeches. And that's true of what I'm saying here today. It'll probably be forgotten by tomorrow. And I'm not going to say go out and follow your dreams like every other graduation speech. But I am going to ask you to remember to go out and lead a meaningful life. Think about things and make wise decisions. Take responsibility for solving problems for yourself and for most of all, for helping others when they are struggling. When we are connected to one another, the journey along the path of life becomes easier and more joyful. So to the graduates and their families, I extend warm congratulations. I know you will accomplish great things, and as the Dr. Seuss book says, oh, the places you will go. Thank you for allowing me to share this wonderful day with you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Jane. That was beautiful. On behalf of StriveU, I would like to thank you for your support of the program. I would like to present you with the honorary degree, which we did. Thank you. Sorry. It is now time to present the Purdue University Global Certificates. To do so, it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Patty Pelletier, Academic Dean at Purdue University Global.
Hello. Thank you, Steve. And my title has changed. So yes, I am Dr. Patty Pelletier, but now I am the Director of Learning and Leadership for Purdue University Global. And so just briefly, I'd like to tell you how Purdue Global partners with StriveU. Purdue Global provides the faculty and the curriculum for the Strive students. The faculty are the amazing Mimi Goth and Glenn Walton. Mimi, could you stand just for a moment? Thank you, Mimi. They are with the students that are graduating today, twice a week, every week from the fall and the spring. The curriculum consists of four courses. These are professional presence, customer service, interpersonal communication, and Microsoft Office applications. And I have to tell you, they're better at Excel than I am. Right? Uh-huh. The skills learned in these courses assist StriveU students to improve fundamental academic skills that foster career opportunities, as well as the basic concepts needed to be independent, contributing members of our community. I've had the pleasure to get to know these students over the past 2 years. I have no doubt in my mind that they are going to be successful in their journey as they move forward. The words that I want to leave with them today are shoot for the moon and become the stars we know each and every one of you are. Congratulations on your achievement.
Thank you, Patty. So, as I read your name, please come forward and accept your Purdue University Global Certificate. Ms. Krista Burrell. Mr. Dylan Maxson. Miss Bridget Parker. Mr. Romeo Peckmode. Miss Molly Snowden. And last but not least, Mr. Owen Walterbeck. Thank you again, Patty. We value our partnership with Purdue University Global. We appreciate the dedication, the commitment, and the enthusiasm of everyone at Purdue Global, and we look forward to future years of collaboration. It is now time to present the graduates with their StriveU Diploma of Higher Education. As we prepare to award these degrees, symbolizing the end of two intense years of preparing for independent living, experiencing competitive employment, participation in post-secondary education, and ultimately transitioning into their own apartments, I would like to take a moment and reflect on these students' achievements. Over the past 2 years, these students have worked very hard on their residential goals at our Nye Street campus. They have taken classes at Purdue University Global. They have set and accomplished individual goals and worked in a variety of jobs. They have participated in community events, elections, they volunteered, and have become active members of their community. They have been busy and have worked extremely hard to reach this point. In addition, they have built friendships and relationships which will continue long after this graduation day. The memories and experiences that have been made at StriveU have created stories that will be told and remembered over and over through the years. Of course, as with any of us, there have been challenging times for our students as well. And hopefully our students have learned and grown through both the successes and the challenges that they have faced. You will have an opportunity to hear some of their reflections today. Students have received support from a variety of places, their families, their friends, their peers, and certainly the StriveU staff. Our team and these graduates have gone through a lot individually and together to reach their goal of independence. And at this time, I'd like to sincerely thank all of our StriveU staff for your hard work and dedication to our students' success. And I'd like to start by quickly thanking some people. I'd like to start by thanking our Student Life Administrator, Ms. Caroline Cole, for her hard work and dedication to this program. Caroline is someone Caroline is someone who has provided leadership within our agency for a number of years in different capacities, but she is still relatively new to the StriveU program, and she has just done a fantastic job with the program, with this team, and you have certainly made a positive impact on the lives of these young students. Thank you, Caroline. And to our wonderful team of coordinators who work so hard to develop and implement the key components of the StriveU program, thank you for the commitment, the follow-through, and the quality that you bring to this program. To our incredible team of teaching assistants who really are the engine that drives the StriveU program each and every day, your work is everything to us and to them. Thank you. And I want to give a big thank you to our community supports team, who are so vital in ensuring that our students feel safe and confident in their surrounding communities. I also want to extend our gratitude to our compassionate and talented professors from Purdue University Global, Mr. Glenn Walton and Ms. Mimi Goff. Your dedication and support has meant so much to our students and to our program. We are so grateful to work with both of you. And our entire team would like to give a very special thank you to our admissions coordinator, Mr. Bill Hughes. Bill not only leads the way with our admissions process, but he is instrumental in organizing many of the special events that we do at StriveU, including today's ceremony. So we thank you, Bill, for your dedication and doing such a great job year in and year out. Thank you. So this juncture is not the end, but a beginning for our students. You have succeeded and will continue to. And I hope that you never stop dreaming and setting goals for yourselves. You each have so much potential. Recognize it and use it well. And I just wanted to add that everybody here is so proud of you guys. And we all hope that each one of you is truly aware and will always remember what a huge inspiration you are to all of us here today, both in our professional lives and in our personal lives. The privilege of being able to share with you this wonderful journey of hard work, of growth and fulfillment, inspires all of us to try harder and to never give up, and also to have the courage to overcome our own fears and our own challenges. Your inspiration awakens us to try and become better human beings every day, and we sincerely thank you for the wonderful gift that you give back to us every day. Thank you, guys. So to our students, Krista, Dylan, Bridget, Romeo, Molly, and Owen, congratulations and well done. As I call each graduate's name, he or she will come forward, give their remarks, and then accept their degree, which StriveU calls these degrees a diploma of higher education, but to these students, they are also a declaration of independence. At this time, I would like to ask Caroline Cole, Student Life Administrator, to come forward and assist in the presentation of these degrees. Krista, would you please come forward?
Hi, my name is Krista. I'd like to welcome everyone to my StriveU graduation. I first heard of StriveU through my Aunt Rachel. She looked up the program for me and mentioned it to my dad. He supported me through the whole application, and I was happy he helped me apply to the program. I found out I got into StriveU while I was at Old Orchard Beach. Bill Hughes called and asked if I would like to come to the StriveU and be a part of this fantastic program. I immediately said yes. I'd like to share some of my favorite experiences of StriveU. The first is meal prep because I feel like I became an awesome cook, and I also like the meals that I make inside my crock pot as well, like chicken noodle soup and chicken bacon ranch sandwiches. In my new apartment, I have a cooking gas stove. I'm a little nervous to use the gas stove, but I know that I'll learn how to be confident while using it. I never knew how to budget money before I came to StriveU. Now I know how to sort my money that I need for my wants versus needs. I really liked being in Shelby's learning group because when I was in high school, I learned a lot of these things, but I got to dig a little deeper into things like healthy versus unhealthy relationships, budgeting, and I learned way more how to cope with stress. I felt like I got to learn in a more upbeat and comfortable classroom. Now I feel more confident to broaden my horizons. I really liked what I learned in Mimi's Purdue Global class, like how to look more professional in a job setting. I was really shocked and proud about getting the highest grade award at the second year presentation. One of my favorite parts of StriveU is community support. I liked going to different places and exploring around Portland, Falmouth, South Portland, and sometimes even Westbrook. My favorite place that we went to in community support was Smiling Hill Farms, and I saw a baby cow. My second favorite place that we went to was Mackworth Island. It's a cool, haunted place to visit. My favorite memory is when I met all of my friends during my first and second year. The 2 years that I've been at StriveU, I've made some pretty awesome friends, and I hope to have them as my lifelong friends. StriveU felt like a roller coaster ride because there was some ups and downs, and sometimes I got stressed, but it was a crazy fun ride with my friends Owen, Romeo, and Dylan, and we all made it through. The things I have planned for my future are hoping to take a child development course so I am able to work with children. I think I'd like to work for a little while and maybe go back to school in a year or two. I really like living independently in my new apartment, and I hope to get a kitten next summer. The advice I have for the first second years is to make it your own roller coaster ride and just have fun. I'd like to say a big thank you to my dad for helping me co-sign on my lease and helping me get furniture for my new apartment. I'd also like to thank my dad for supporting me by coming to my quarterlies, and because you are the one person that I look up to and who I can call my hero. I'd like to say thank you to my mom for being around in spirit and watching over me. I'd also like to thank all of my family for your love and support. You mean a great deal to me. I'd also like to thank all my friends that I made here throughout StriveU. Thank you to my roommate, Ashley, and last but certainly not least, thank you to all the StriveU staff. Thank you for making a crazy fun ride throughout my 2 years at StriveU.
Thank you, Krista. Dylan, would you please come forward?
My name is Dylan, and I want to thank you for coming to our graduation. Here are some things I would like to tell all of you about my experience here at StriveU. When I first got to StriveU, I was nervous, and I was able to get over my fear of living in a new place. I have learned so much. I have learned how to navigate around Portland, and I have learned how to cook, clean, and budget my money. My favorite meal I cooked during meal prep was lasagna roll-ups. My favorite goal was cooking. My favorite memory was going to Funtown Splash Town, and my other favorite memory was when Sarah M. slipped on the mud during community support. During my time at StriveU, I worked at Drummond Woodsum. I would like to thank Amy and all of the staff for a great experience. My future plans are moving back to Florida, getting a dog, and getting a full-time job. I want to thank my mom for helping me get into StriveU and for all of her support. Over the last 2 years, I would like to thank my staff for helping me with my goals, and I'd like to thank my roommate for being a good friend and a good roommate. Here is my favorite quote, the three C's in life are choice, chance, and change. You must make a choice to take a chance, or your life will never change. Thank you for coming to my graduation.
Thank you, Dylan. Bridget, would you please come forward?
My name is Bridget, and welcome to my StriveU graduation. It has been a long 2 years, but I made it through with a quote that always helped me. Nobody is ordinary. We are all extraordinary. I stick by this because it tells me to treat others with respect and never to give up. Strive was awesome. The goals really helped me learn how to live on my own. They taught me how.
We really apologize. I think we're having a little mic problem. Sorry, guys. With this, but oh, there we go. Thank you. So, Romeo, would you please come forward?
Hello, my name is Romeo, and I want to thank you for being here today. In my first year at StriveU, I realized it was definitely different than living my home in Brunswick. When I first moved in, I was not nervous at all, but I knew it was going to be different from now on, because I realized after this, I'll be living my own place. So the first week was really busy. It was just activity after activity. They kept us busy all the time. My favorite memory from that week, and probably my all-time favorite memory, was when we went to Peaks Island. We split into two groups. The groups that I was with explored the island. My group included Owen, Dylan, Jasmine, and Hunter. We went into the old mill. It was a tunnel. It was really dark in there. When we walked through, we started scaring each other. It was super funny. When we walked through it again, we heard this weird voice in a video that I took. I am independent in all my goals now, so I do not need help from any staff. By doing our goals independently, this will help us live in our new apartments. My favorite goal is meal prep and community support. In meal prep, my favorite food to make was stromboli and hamburgers with cheese, bacon, lettuce, and tomatoes. My experience here has been awesome. My second favorite goal is community support. For sure, we call it CS. In CS, we go and navigate to places that we want. There, by walking or taking a bus, my favorite place to go is to Peaks Island, or will be Eastern Palm, the Audubon's, Oakland Trails, and last, the Evergreen Cemetery. In the past 2 years, I have experienced so many wonderful things and I have met so many amazing people. I would like to thank all the staff who have helped me and also put up with my shenanigans. You helped me to become the independent person I am today, and I really appreciate all your support. I want to thank my mom for everything. From the start of the time that I came to this country and the time that she has adopted me, I couldn't ask for a better mother and a family. This is my quote. Life is like a roller coaster. You have your ups and downs and sometimes your loops. It can be funny and it can also be scary. At the end of the ride, you realize that you had a good life and enjoyed the ride. Thank you for coming to our graduation.
Thank you, Romeel, and thank you for your shenanigans. Molly, would you please come forward?
Hello, my name is Molly Snowden, and welcome to my 2019 graduation. When I first got to StriveU, I was so nervous and upset. But after making new friends and trying new things, it made me want to live and be happy by myself. I learned how to do a lot of goals and skills at StriveU, including cooking, cleaning, laundry, budgeting, shopping, and navigating the community properly. All those things just made me want to keep doing them, but on different days and times. I really love cleaning best because it keeps every room in my apartment nice and shiny, and makes the air in them smell really good too. I went to new places in the community, including the Western Prom, the Walmart of Falmouth, the Point, and Home 2 Suites. They were pretty good when I went to them for the first time. When I went to Learning Group, I learned about healthy relationships, nutrition, and money. When I went to Purdue Global Class, I learned about professional things like customer service and interpersonal communication. I started working at PSL Services last July, and I work 2 days and 16 hours a week. I learned how to do more work in an office, like billing, emailing, faxing, and checking receipts. My favorite memory from StriveU is when I went to one of my favorite amusement parks, Funtown Splashtown, with everyone, including my old roommates, Emily Murray and Siobhan Guile, 2 summers ago. What I want to do next is live in my own place in South Portland, take a trip to London, England, work at PSL Services 3 days and 12 hours a week, and go to a day program 1, 2, or 3 mornings a week. Because I can't only do goals, exercise, shop, and go to special events all the time. I want to thank my mom, my dad, my friend Erica Whiting, and especially all the StriveU staff for helping me with everything I needed to get done. Because when they do their own goals and plans, they taught me how to do the same as them before moving to StriveU. I also want to thank some of my other friends in StriveU for staying together with me when we went to old and new places outdoors and working together with me on what will happen next. Sometimes I can visit StriveU on regular days or social events clubs if I want to. First year students, try to remember this quote I found online. The struggle you're in today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow. That means if you think something new you need to try is hard, but you try it anyway and it gets easier, you'll be able to do it again in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Molly. Owen, would you please come forward?
Hi, my name is Owen. Thank you for coming to our graduation. This is a day of mixed emotions for me as I'm excited to be moving on, but I'll also realize that I will not be returned to StriveU. This is a very special day where my peers and I get to celebrate the 2 years of hard work and incredible amount of learning that we have accomplished. It is also the day that our families get to celebrate with us. Being here at StriveU has been a blast. During my 2 years here, I have learned a ton. Having learned a group with Shelby has been amazing. Just coming in and having her say good morning is something I will miss a lot. Our work in class helped us in so many ways to be able to live independently. During my time at StriveU, I had Glenn and Mimi for my Purdue Global classes. They always seemed to make classes very interesting. I enjoyed working on all my goals except for laundry. The goal I enjoyed the most was meal prep. When I came to StriveU, I basically knew how to make eggs. Now I can cook independently and not burn anything. My two favorite recipes that I made were honey garlic chicken and fried chicken. I'm working at Maine Medical Center, and I hope to grow further in my career while working there. One of my favorite memories is when I got Sue to laugh. We were talking about the weather, and I was answering her questions really fast, and then she asked me a question I couldn't answer. And she said, gotcha! And I couldn't stop laughing, and that made my day. Just one more day, just one more time, just one more tear, just one last laugh is all I ask from StriveU. A question to Caroline, may I stay one more year, maybe five? I would like to say thank you to all the staff for helping me and all of us out during our goals. I would also like to thank them for making our 2 years at StriveU fun and enjoyable while we were learning so much. I would also like to say thank you to both of my parents for supporting me while I was here. My advice to the second years is something Caroline told me when I was surprisingly being stubborn. She told me that I need to have an open mind. When you are open to things and change, you can grow and become more independent. But as Matthew McConaughey likes to say, all right, all right, all right. So now I guess this is where I wrap things up and say I did it. It's never a goodbye, but I'll see you around. Thank you.
Thank you, Owen. So now, will the graduates please rise? Congratulations, you made it. Now we're gonna move the tassels over. Huge round of applause for the StriveU class of 2019. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to reintroduce Caroline Cole, who will give our closing remarks.
Today is a tremendous day for everyone in this auditorium. For parents, family, and friends, it's a day of celebration. Your support and guidance has helped to steer these students towards their goal of independence. For faculty and staff, it's a day to reflect on the completion of another successful class of StriveU students. And for the StriveU class of 2019, today is a milestone that you've been working to reach for 2 years. You got here through incredibly hard work and persistence. We have asked a lot of you. You've completed countless hours of goals in class, held multiple jobs, and been asked to show up every single day ready to learn. We know at times this wasn't easy, but now you're graduating, and you deserve to be very proud of what you've accomplished. After 2 short, maybe long, years, all of you are living in your own apartments, and now ahead of you lies a life you have chosen for yourselves. We do not know what the future can hold, but I'm confident that you all have the skills and abilities to be successful and thrive in whatever life you choose to lead. Krista, you are a very kind person. Your peers, employers, professors, staff, and anyone who meets you knows that your kindness and positivity makes you wonderful to be around. Your positivity is evident throughout every aspect of your life. You're even upbeat during your goals and classes, which is really saying something because I've heard cleaning goal isn't fun. Dylan, you once said that your dream was to live in your own apartment in Portland, and here you are. You've persevered through the program even when it wasn't easy. You've always had big dreams while you've been at StriveU, whether it's living on your own, cooking really complicated meal preps, or beating the latest video game. Keep working hard towards those goals because you can do almost anything you set your mind to. Bridget, you are confident and outgoing. It is a skill to welcome new people with open arms and to maintain friendships, two things you do very well. To watch you walk confidently into a room or give a presentation with ease is inspiring. You are so appreciative. To say thank you and really mean it is a skill you know well. I hope you continue to try new things and be warm and friendly. Romeo, a lot comes to mind when I think of you, but the things in the forefront are how responsible and reliable you are. For the past few months, you've held 2 different jobs, and you've continued to be very diligent about following your budget to make sure all your needs are met. In addition to your incredible work ethic and DJ skills, you are just so much fun to be around. I think that we can all agree we'll miss your jokes. Molly, your drive towards independence and perfection is inspiring. You are organized, punctual, and a very hard worker. We give you a lot of feedback on how to improve in goals, work, and skills. With your dedication to your goal of independence, you have become the woman who sits here today, someone who has their own apartment, job, hobbies, and life. Whether you're working towards your 10,000 steps for the day or being interviewed by CNN, you've always put your best foot forward. Owen, it shouldn't surprise anyone that I would describe you as a leader amongst your peers. It is wonderful to watch you bring your peers together. If someone had told me the Owen I met 4 years ago would become the person who sits here today, I wouldn't have believed it. You've grown into an outgoing, social, and responsible individual. You have also grown your already very large speaker collection. Graduates, it has been a joy to know you. As a group and as individuals, you are inspiring. Your accomplishments in these past 2 years truly seem endless. I hope you always believe in yourselves, and even when times get tough, those are the learning opportunities that will make you stronger in the end. Continue to dream big because you can do it. While StriveU journey ends today, your new journey of living your own life independently begins now. Thank you for sharing this exciting day with us. We welcome you all to a reception immediately following the ceremony in the lobby outside of the auditorium. You are welcome to use the tables in the lobby, but we do ask that no food be taken into the turf field. At this time, let us join together to congratulate the StriveU class of 2019.